How are you? Hope you all are doing fine at your homes. Today I will start with the second chapter, that is kingdom classification. So now first of all we will discuss what classification is actually. The grouping of different kind of things on the basis of certain characteristics, their common characteristics is called classification. Now again next one is a biological classification. Now the grouping of different kind of organisms on the basis of their common characteristics, their similarities, is called our biological classification. And the branch of science which deals with the classification of organisms is called taxonomy. There are two systems of classification. First one is artificial system of classification and the natural system of classification. This system of classification was given by the Aristotle. According to Aristotle, in artificial system of classification, only superficial characteristics are taken into consideration. For example, size of a plant, length of a plant. For example, mango tree and pine tree, both are considered in this artificial system of classification. And in your natural system of classification, they are based on the their internal structure, their outer structure, and based on the growth and development. But afterwards, Carolus Linnaeus, he proposed two kingdom classification, that is your based on the Plantia and Animalia. As the name indicates, kingdom of plants contains Plantae, which can prepare their own food but did not move, and the Animalia, which could move but not able to prepare their food by themselves. Now, a question will arise in our mind, what is the actually advantages of having this classification? Why we have to classify the different organisms and different plants in a classified manner in some kind of a class? Why have to put these all plants and animals around us in a particular class? So, the different types of advantages are, first one is identify different organisms. As you all know, we are having wide variety of plants and animals. For identifying their different organisms and plants, we have to classify them in a particular group. Our second one is, it helps us to study the systematically and easily the basic nature of the organisms. For example, birds. If you will take birds, parrots, if we are having pigeons, crows, they all are in one group. Why they all are in one group? Because they are having feathers. Second one, they are having wings. Third one, they are having a rigid exoskeleton, endoskeleton they are having. So they all are in this particular Aves group. Third one is relationship between different organisms. Now they are classified according to their relationships in between. For example, water animals. Example, if you will take fish, piranha, you will take different kind of fishes. They all are present in the water. That means they are having some kind of a relationship in between. That is why they are placed in that water animal categories. Evolution from complex to the simple one. Simple to the complex one. They are evolved from the simple form, very simple form. Earlier they were in a very simple form. And now they are becoming complex. Day by day they are becoming the complex ones. Third one is the, fourth one. Fifth one is actually, characteristics of all members can be studied. With the help of one or two members, it will take a little amount of some kind of organisms, we can able to judge the other animals also. Again, if we will take the example of the birds, same, they are having wings, they are having feathers, and they can fly freely in the sky. With the help of 2, 3 or you can say 10 birds, we can actually classify them in the members of Aves. Now, we have discussed the system of classification, that is artificial and natural. Afterwards, we have discussed two kingdom classification, that is Plantae and Animalia. But this classification was not up to the mark, that because of Euglena. As Euglena is considered as a plant, but it also possesses the characteristics of your animals. So, scientists are in a need to propose a new system of classification. So R.H. Whittaker, in the year 1969, he proposed and arranged all the organisms in the five kingdoms. Based on their similarities, their dissimilarities, Whittaker actually divided all the animals and plants in these five kingdoms. First one is a Monera, second one is a Protista, third one is a Fungi, fourth one is a Plantae, and the fifth one is a Animalia. First, we will discuss the Monera one. Monera consists of unicellular organisms. Protista also consists of unicellular organisms. Now, question will arise, if both will consist of unicellular organisms, why they are in different kingdoms? So, here is the second difference. They consist of prokaryotic cells and Protista consists of eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells, that means they don't have the well-defined nucleus. Whereas Protista have the eukaryotic cells, that means they are having well-defined nucleus. Now, next one is our fungi. They both are having unicellular vectors and prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Let's see what's other difference in fungi. Now, fungi is having both unicellular and multicellular organisms. Mostly have a well-defined nucleus. One difference from the Monera and Protista that they are having multicellular organisms also. And they are, some of them are heterotrophs also. For example, they feed on a dead organic matter. You are eating mushrooms at home, white colored mushrooms you are eating at home. It is an example of fungi only. Then this next one is a Plantae. So let's see what is the other difference plants is Plantae kingdom is having from these three. Now Plantae is having first of all multicellular organisms. Multicellular organism, fungi is also having the multicellular organisms. But the next one is they are autotrophs. They prepare their own food. They are having a cell wall around their cell structures. So these are the differences which made Plantae different from these others. And the fifth one is our Animalia. They are also multicellular like Plantae, but they are not autotrophs. They are heterotrophs. They cannot prepare their own food. They have to depend on others for their food. Now Animalia is again classified into two types. First one is invertebrates and the second one is vertebrates. Invertebrates means those who are not having any kind of backbones. And vertebrates means those are having backbone. Now, some examples of invertebrates are worms, your insects, small insects, water animals, some kind of like jellyfish is there. They're not having the proper backbone with them. And vertebrates are having a huge variety of organisms in it. For example, human beings, for example, your crocodile. All we are having a kind of backbone, rigid backbone. With the help of that backbone, we are able to move from here and there. Thank you. We will conclude our lecture here only. We'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you. Stay safe, stay home.